सो हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू चैनल गेट टू बाइट। सो फ्रॉम नाउ ऑन आई विल बी स्टार्टिंग अ ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज ऑन एसटीएम 8 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स ऑल्सो विच इज आर 8 बिट माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स पावर्ड बाय एसटीएम माइक्रो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आई विल बी डायरेक्टली स्टार्टिंग ऑन दिस माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स एम्बेडेड सी बेयर मेटल प्रोग्रामिंग टोटली फ्रॉम स्क्रैच एज आई हैव डन फॉर द एवीआर 8 बिट माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कनेक्टिंग टू दिस एसटीएम 8S टू आर स्टीलिंग प्रोग्रामर। So before that, I will just give you a brief introduction for this STM8S ICs and its development board. So these are the cheap development board which you can get easily from Flipkart or Amazon or from any robotics website, electronics website. And these have the onboard LED, PB test LED and the power LED, and the test LED is connected to our GPIO pins. And this is the USB connector for directly connecting it to the Type-C to the Android cable, just like Arduino Nano or our ESP32826 are powered. And this is the SWIM protocol pinout, SWIM and NR reset, through which it will be connected to our ST-Link programmer, which is an in-circuit debugger for flashing programs into our STM8 microcontrollers and also for debugging it. So I have connected this STM8S via to my ST-Link programmer via SWIM, NR reset, ground and 3.3 volt. This completes our connection for the SWIM protocol through which it will be flashed and debugged. Now for powering our microcontroller, we will be connecting this plus and minus 5 voltage, plus and minus. It has to be powered with plus 5 voltage, which will also power from the ST-Link V2 plus 5 voltage and the ground. So now, as you complete your connections, now we will move on to its software development kit. So now, as you complete your connection and power, connect your this red and black and white wires which power the 5 voltage from a ST-Link programmer only, and just start the USB connected to the USB hub. It will power your ST-Link will also programmer, and your test power LED on the STM8S with blue color will also power. So now, let's move forward. So now, starting with STM8, first we will look into its software development tools. For the explanation of STM8 software development tools, I find this website very good. On there is an article on circuitdigest.com which fully explains its software development kit and its which tools are there for programming it, and which compilers and STVP, the ST Visual Programmer, ST Visual Dex developed for writing code on it. So you can check out this website for installing the software toolchain to your PC. I will give the link in the video description. Now we will be starting with our main code, as I am going to show you how to write the GPIO LED blink sketch in embedded C codes using the bare metal programming and the registers from the data sheet. Now you just open the ST Visual Develop. Okay. Now as you open the ST Visual Develop, go to the new workspace, create project and workspace, and just first it asks for the workspace location. I am changing that thing to my preferred location, that is on my document sections. I have created a folder with the name STM8 codes. So I will be using that. You can use your workspace location as per your preference and workspace file name. And there is an option for by default creating the folder under your workspace STM8 codes for your project name. So I will be naming that way also. So I am naming them as STM8_tutorials. Okay, was created. Now it has created the specified folder name. Now STM8S_tutorials. Again, for naming my workspace, click on OK. Project file name, and I am naming this as blink_LED. Okay. And under my STM8 codes, under STM8 tutorials, it will create the LED blink_LED project LED repository, Cosmic compiler, and it will automatically root its path file, and then click on OK. then it will ask for the control the controller which you are using. Then you just click on 8S103F3P, select, and then click on OK. Now you will see that it will be created, has created your files, source files and the include files. As if now there will be no include files in your program, but we will need to include two source files for accessing the memory registers in of a microcontroller. So for that, go to the add files to folder, and now just navigate to this STM8S standard peripheral library. This you have to download from the STM website. Okay, you will get, I will upload the link on the video description. Just download that file and unzip the folder and copy that folder to the workspace which you have mentioned when creating your project. So as I have mentioned the STM8 code, so I have copied my STM8S standard peripheral library folder to here. Click over here and navigate to libraries, STM8S include and STM8S.h, and then click open. Okay, now again we have to add one more file. Now just navigate to the previous standard peripheral life project. You can click into any of the previous option. Click on GPIO top Google and click on STM8S_configure.h and then click open. Now your both of include files will be opened over here. Now in the STM8S.h, you need to, as you are doing it for the first time, then you have to first uncomment your hashtag defined microcontroller which you are using. So I have uncommented my hashtag defined STM8S103, and in the STM8S configure.h, there is a small change that you have to do, otherwise it will show you an error. You just have to uncomment this hashtag define useful assert. Okay, if you will not uncomment it, then it will show you an error. So if it shows you that error, then just uncomment it. Okay, now we will move to our main.c. Now moving to our main.c, we will just write the code. Now if you will go to our source and main.c file, you must have, it will be showing you some while and the initialization. Just remove that thing and just copyright this code. So this is the code which I have written for toggling my GPIO LED 5, the onboard LED which is on the PB5 of which is mapped to my PB5 of the STM8S microcontroller. So I have first defined so for GPIO we have three registers in STM8. PB_ODR, PB_DDR and PB_CR1. So for PB_ODR, we will equate it to the 0x00. That will turn all of my port D pins to my 0. Okay, port B pins, not port D. Here it is port B. Port B pins to by default 0. That is, they are by default output. That is by default their pull up is low. Now DDR we have configured as this is output. So the bit 5 PB_DDR for configuring the output and input, and PB_CR1 for high, for setting the pin high and low, and PB_ODR for activating the pull up and pull down resistors. So by default pulling down all the resistors, and these are the, in the starting I have defined hashtag define the memory address of these functions so that it can be directly mapped to my microcontroller memory peripheral GPIO registers. Okay, so this is my, as I have told you, this is my pull up and down, this is my output and input, and this is my setting high and low. So now first setting the pull low, that is all these are pull low by default. PB5 as my output and PB5 as my push pull, that is by default it is being set as high. Now under the while section we will go and we will just toggle our PB_ODR, that is push pull or push low. So toggling it to 1 <5, this is bit manipulation. And then under the for loop we are generating delay of around 1 second by using this for loop. Okay, so this is simple STM8 GPIO embedded C code. Okay, so now you just go here and build your program and click on yes. Now it will build with zero errors and zero warnings. Okay, and now you have built your program. Now just go and we will use our STVP to program into our microcontroller. So double click on STVP, and as it will open, you will see this window. Now in this, there are a bunch of options that you can do over here. Can program your memory, you can data memory, and you can option set up your option bytes also. So for now we will not look into this. We will just go to your program tab and just click on all tabs, and just this is my hardware as we have connected it. Okay, so program all tabs. Now you will see that it has programmed successfully, and this blue LED has been turned into red. That means my program has been successfully uploaded on my microcontroller. And now just I have to reset the ST-Link programmer once so as to run the programmer on my microcontroller. So click over this icon and click on OK. As you click on this, you will see that your LED will start blinking. Oh, okay, wait, it is not blinking. Okay, guys, we have not selected a project. So yeah, just remember this to not do such things, otherwise you will just keep on scratching your mind at what is your fault. So just go to the file, open, and open your debug. When you have compiled your code, under your debug folder, just click on blink_ledd.s19. So we will be flashing this s19 file in a microcontroller. So open it. And now we will program. So now just click on all tabs, and now it will be uploaded. Now just click over here and then click OK. So now as you will see, this blink sketch has started and my LED is blinking in an interval of 1 second. Okay, so this is a GPIO blink LED sketch. STM8 totally from embedded C. You can refer out for these details from the STM8 test datasheet also. So that's it for now, guys. I hope you all like the video and you get to know about something. If you get to know about something and you like, then do subscribe the channel and kindly subscribe to press the notification bell to get notified for the new videos that will be uploaded on STM8 test, embedded C, and microcontrollers, and also developing its application code for various peripherals. So that's it now for guys. See you in the next video.